Hello and welcome to Suggest Cloud. In this tutorial, I'll show you how to create a VM instance using Oracle Cloud Console. But before we begin, before creating an instance, we can create a single instance using the Compute Web Console. While creating an instance, we can specify persistent storage volume to be associated with our instance. We can also enable access to our instance using SSH key. The SSH key will be creating beforehand. I already have an SSH key, so I'll be using that SSH key to access the instance. And we can also add a security list to our instance, and we can control the access to our instance. So let's get started. So this is our Oracle Cloud Console. From the quick action also, we can go ahead and create a VM instance. And from the top left menu, you just hover the menu from the core infrastructure, compute, and just click on instance. You can see this instance will be created in the root compartment. I already have a couple of instances running, and you can choose the instance to be created in which compartment. Either you can choose a root compartment or any other sub compartments. So I am creating this compartment in my root compartment, so I'll click on create instance. I'm giving the name SG test 3. I'm going to select the same Oracle Linux 7.7 operating system. And from the show save network storage option, I'll select the free eligible availability domain and then virtual machine. The instance shape is one core CPU and then 1 GB of memory. We can also select the VCN configured network, and the VCN would be the same root compartment, and this is the default VCN which is there in the root compartment, and subnet would be the same as an root compartment, and this is a public subnet. Now here this is very important thing where you will have an option to either do not assign public IP or you can assign a public IP. Now in case if I'll select this option, assign public IP, this can be a security concern where anyone can access this instance. But as of now, I'll not assigning any public IPs. But later what I'm going to do is, in this tutorial, I'll go ahead and reserve one public IP, and then I am assigning that public IP to this particular instance which I am going to create it right now, so that you will get a concept of how to create an instance without having a public IP, and how to assign a reserved public IP to a instance. So this will be a good exercise to understand how to assign a public IP. So let's do that. I am not selecting anything from this console. I'll just go ahead and say do not assign it. Then we have to select the SSH key. I'm selecting this public SSH key, and then I'll say create. Now it is going to provision. Probably in next couple of minutes it will be ready. You can see this public IP address is unavailable because I have not assigned any public IP to this instance. So hopefully this will be completed in a couple of minutes. This is in progress. You can see the progress from work request. You just click on it. It will show you create instance is in progress. 15% is completed. And if you want to see the more logs, you can see the log file as well as the error log is also shown here. You can see there is it is going to create it, and 15% is completed. Maybe in a few seconds it will be ready. So let's wait for that. You can see public private IP is already assigned to this instance. And then AD, fault domain, reason, what is the shape, VCN, right? When this is when this has launched, this has launched this is the current date, image 7.7. This is a launch mode, para virtualized. We have two mode. This is one of them. Other one is iSCSI, right? So you could see the SG test instance is created now. It is now running. But if you want to access this instance, let's go ahead and assign one of the public IP. Then we can attach that public IP to VNICs. So how to do that? We'll go ahead and click on top left menu and go to networking and then public IP. You can see there is one reserved public IP for instance I have already created, which is assigned to another instance. I'll go ahead and create a new public IP, which is PIP for SG test 3. This will be in the root compartment. I'll give public IP for SG test 3. I'll go ahead and say click create it. So this is the public IP, right? So now I do have a public IP. What I'm going to do is I'll go ahead and go back to instance SG test. This is SG test, and you can see there is no public IP assigned to it. And I'll go to attached VNIC. This is attached VNIC. I'll click this, click on the VNIC, and then I'll go ahead and click on IP address. This is assigned private IP. Private IP is this one. I'll go and say edit, and then I'll say reserved public IP. Assign a reserved public IP. Now, which public IP you want to assign? This reserved public IP is already assigned to a private IP, and this I'll assign it to SG test 3 150.136.131.191. Now this is assigned. How to confirm? I'll go back to instance and I'll go to SG test 3. Now you can see here the public IP is assigned. Now this public IP will use this public IP to connect to from the putty, and we'll try to do a couple of activities. One will update yum update, and then we'll try to install a web server, and we'll try to create a web page. So let's do that. Let me clear the screen. I'll copy the public IP, and then I am going to open a new session. I'll give this public IP. I'll select the SSH key. This is the private key. Then I'll go to appearance and change to italic 16, and anything else? No, let's do that, and I'll try to open it. Now this is asking, this server host key is not changed, cache is in the registry, you have no guarantee that the server is computer, you think it. So I'll say yes, you cache this, and then I'll give OPC. Now you are logged into SG test 3. I'll say host name minus I. I'll do a couple of host name, uname. Say this is Linux server, which we already know that. And then we'll just elevate our access to root so that we can do a couple of activity. Yum update. Let's see if there is any update for this Linux server. It is now plugins are loaded. It will search for the new update, and maybe in a couple of seconds you will see there could be if there is any available update, it will update it. Right, so it is now searching for the package. It is saying yes, 1.1 MB of the update is available. It is going to update one by one. Right, so it is updated now. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to install httpd and then I'm giving minus y so that it won't ask me to say either you want to update it or not. I'm just giving it beforehand. So now what I have this web server, then service httpd status. And then I will say status. It is running now. Earlier it was not running, now it is running. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to add a firewall rule so that 80 port it will allow me to do the TCP IP 80 port. So what I'm going to do is I'll give a firewall command. I'll just say sudo firewall, and then it will allow me to access the port number 80, or you can go to your VCN and then you can add this firewall rule. Once this is added, I have to sudo firewall, I have to reload it. I'm going to reload this. Sudo firewall reload. It is saying yes, success. Now now the IP which I have is let's see if I'm able to open this web page or not. Let's wait, see. This web page Apache 2 test page is come up. This is web server. Now on this web server we can design the web page. So where we have to go, we have to go to cd var www.html and then cd, I'll go to cd, I'll just delete this one, cd var, and there is nothing. I'll create a index.html, and inside that index.html I'll create one html, and then h1 heading 1. This is my Oracle Cloud instance, and then I'll close the tag html and I'm going to save it. Now let's see if so what I have done is I have gone to cd dollar, I'll go to cd dollar var html, and I have created this vi, I have created this index.html, and I have given this command called html. I have started the html tag and then heading. This is my first Oracle Cloud instance, and I'll go ahead and save it. Now I'll go back and I'll see whether I am able to access the web page or not. So let's refresh it. Right, so this is my Oracle Cloud instance. So in this way you can create any web server page using the Oracle instance, and in this way you can create any instance, Linux instance, Windows instance, and you can do a lot of work. You can also see the mount points. You can see it has some mount point added, 39 GB, right? So 200 MB SD1 block volumes are added. In this way, you can do a lot of work. So hope this is helpful to you. Let me know in the comment section if you need any more help on this. I'll glad to help you on that.